Let's get back to this. What I've shown you is a few examples of how easy it is to misread C code. And another similar topic a few years ago, on 2014, there was a huge cry about a bug in the security socket layer of Apple's software, which affected both computers and portable devices, because the secure socket library by Apple's had a severe security problem. The piece of code that's related to that is shown. I'm showing it on this page. Can you guess where is the error here?
The use of GoTo.
It's related to the use of GoTo, but it's not using GoTo that's causing the problem. They could have the GoTo and everything would be working without any problem.
There's one extra GoTo that always goes.
Right. There is an extra GoTo that is not protected by any if. So we have a series of tests. If error is that, go to fail. If error is that, go to fail, etc., etc., etc. And there is one extra go to fail that is always executed. There is no if protecting that go to fail. And this is enough to that was enough to make this code fail. And as a matter of fact, this code was introduced in 2012. And the problem was only detected in 2014. So all these devices were around during 2 years with problems in their secure socket layer. I will leave the PDF files, and you can have links to some more detail about this. So one of the ways for solving this is to use coding standards. What are coding standards? It's a collection of coding rules, guidelines, and best practice. And they aim at making the software safer. And it means that it does not cause accidents when it's used, secure. You don't have logins from people who should not have logins, etc. It's reliable. When I use it, when I need it, I can use it. It's testable, so I can verify that it's running or not, or it's doing the right thing before I put it to work. It's maintainable. So if I need to produce new versions, I can pick up the old code and make a new version. And then I can make it portable. So because I may need to have the same software working in different environments. For instance, in the previous example, it was the same socket layer that would work in the macOS, in the Apple computers running macOS, or in the portable devices running iOS. And these are very different environments, and I need the same piece of code, in this case, the software, secure software layer, to work on both of them. And so the idea is to define rules that avoid the kind of problems that we have seen before. And one of them, and one of the most important for embedded systems, and particularly for reliable embedded systems, is this MISRA C. MISRA is the Motor Industry Software Reliability Association. This is an association with headquarters in the United Kingdom. And they developed a coding guide for reliable embedded systems. You can buy this this document. It's they distribute it as a PDF. And as a matter of fact, if you are going to if you go in your profession and start developing embedded systems, I recommend that you read this carefully. This is quite affordable. The price for the MISRA C standard is about £15, so that would be below 20 euros. And it's one of the most important documents saying with definitions about good practices for developing embedded system. And so this consists on a set of rules that in fact limit the use of what C allows us to do. And it imposes some rules that are more strict than what the programmer allows in order to avoid the problems like those we have seen before. So this is why it is a restricted subset of the language. So we don't use anything that's possible to do with the language. We have seen the problems of going that way. It doesn't talk about style. Style means how you write your code. For instance, if you make indentation with 2 spaces, 4 spaces, or 8 spaces, if when you write a function, you write curly braces in the same line, or if you change line and begin the curly braces on the next line, if you embed when you write switch case, if you indent the case word or not. So style has a lot, is how you present your code. That's static only. It makes the code easier to read, and MISRA does not talk about it. And the main purpose of MISRA is to be applied in automotive embedded systems. MISRA is an association related to the automotive industry. But the requirements expressed here can be applied to any kind of embedded systems when we want our code to be reliable. And so I would like you to take a few minutes just to have a look at what is MISRA. In the e-learning, you have a folder which contains the MISRA C rules. And inside there is a document called IAR Embedded Workbench MISRA C Reference Guide. This is a document from IAR, which are a developer of system software for embedded systems. And they have published a document on the previous version of MISRA, which was the 2004 version. Back to the presentation. All of this must be seen in the context of developing software, and so we need to make sure that we have a process, meaning rules, to create software, and this implies and includes a lot of things like a documented development process. So when you work, you should have rules clearly define how to develop code. And it has to do with things like project management, who does what, configuration management, hazard or risk analysis, and then all steps of development like getting requirements, making design, coding to verify software is doing what is expected to do, etc. And so there are other key issues besides the choosing a language which is to use or not to use a style guide in order that everyone writes code in the same way. Choose a compiler and validate that the compiler is adequate. and then having checking tools validate your code. Besides applying all these rules, having tools that verify that everything is working okay, and metrics, which means having some ways of measuring your software, which is what we will be talking next about, tools for validate and metrics. And so besides the coding standards, we have, as we have seen before, we can have style guides. And for instance, if you are working in a team, everyone should follow the same style guide. So you should have a style guide for everyone to use the same style to create code that has always the same looking. And the issues that are mentioned on style guide can be code layout, layout of braces, statement complexity, etc. And they define how should we organize our software. For instance, to show you a concrete example of what can style guides include. Let's, for instance, edit this source file, and there is a C program which you may find useful sometimes, which is called indent, and indent is a program to control the indentation of your software along different styles, which are the styles that I'm talking about. And it has a lot of options, like should I include or not blank lines after declaration? Should there be blank lines after procedure? So there are a lot of different options that shape the code in different ways. And we have several styles here. For instance, we have here the GNU style. So if I use to use indent, one of the simplest ways is to define the style, and then notice that the appearance of the code has changed. This is the GNU style. When I have a function, I have the type, and then the new line, the name of the function. The curly braces do not follow the name and the arguments, but they are printed on the next line. I can use, let's just make the two windows visible. Another style is by Kernighan and Ricci, which are the creators, people who wrote the first book on C. I can format along this style, and now you see that this has changed. It has different styles for writing code. And so this is the purpose of a coding a style guide. Well, the GNU has also, so we talked about the GNU style, and related to GNU is the GNOME project, and they also have their style guide, and we see that there are definitions that may contradict between different organizations. For instance, we have seen that Misra C, Misra C always imposes to use braces in after an if statement. In the case of the code that we are seeing here, there should be open braces and closed braces after each statement. to avoid the problem that we have seen in the secure socket layer by Apple. And for instance, the GNOME style recommends the opposite, only use braces for multiple statements, statement blocks. Obviously, the context is another, is different. MISRA C is for reliable software, and GNOME is for user interfaces in PC. So the problem of having errors is not of the same dimension in these two situations.